Hey guys, Katie. So today's video is not in the slightest exciting. I don't know how to ease up to it, so I'm just gonna just say it. My hamster, Clover, passed away last night. To be honest, I have no idea what happened. Like, her cage was completely set up right. She looked fine, too. Like, she had no goop on her eyes. Her bottom wasn't wet, so she didn't have wet tail. She just showed no signs. She didn't have a tumor. She showed no signs of sickness or aging, and I just have no idea what happened. My mom was doing some research, and she said that sometimes hamsters just die even if they don't, even if they haven't reached their lifespan. Sometimes it's just genetics, and they just pass from bad genetics. And since I adopted her, that would make sense. I didn't get her from a high quality breeder or anything like that. So I guess that makes more sense than anything, but it just breaks my heart because I really miss her and I wish she was still here with us. She passed away, thankfully, really, really peacefully in her nest and all snuggled up, and she just looked really happy even though she passed. And even though it's not gonna be fun, I know I gave her a really good life, and I know that she passed away peacefully and in her sleep, most importantly, and happily, and just that makes me feel better than just knowing I just spent her whole life in a critter trail or something like that. So she passed away the 26th of January 2019, and I got her March 17th 2018, so it was getting closer to her gotcha day. I hadn't even had her for a year, and yeah, I wished I could have spent her gotcha day with her. My dad is going to call our vet and PetSmart even, and just a few different places to see if there are any ways to either cremate her or bury her, if there are any other options for what to do with her body. As far as if I'm gonna get another hamster, I will probably pretty soon. The way that I cope with hamsters' passings is I honestly just get another hamster. It just makes me feel a little bit better. I don't have to just look at an empty cage and wonder, like, just think about her all the time. So definitely replacing the hamster is my coping mechanism. I'd like to get a robo this time, and if possible a female robo. Kind of wanted a robo for a while, but now I'm wondering maybe not. That was kind of when I was thinking that I would when Sammy would die first, because that makes more sense. Because Sammy's not very affectionate towards me, and Clover really was, so even if this new hamster wasn't affectionate, I'd still have Clover. But since Clover died, that kind of changed my plans, so I'm not really sure what I'm gonna do. I might just do it anyway, like, just handle Sammy more and make sure that he does become affectionate, like maybe restart the taming process even. So I don't know, I'm gonna have to figure this out. I don't have it all figured out yet. We'll be inserting like a slideshow thingy like I did for Elliot at the end of this video, so you guys can go ahead and watch it. But yeah, like my first hamster that I was actually really attached to that had passed away. If any of you guys have had a hamster that has passed away, my condolences. I know what it feels like now, and I know that you probably feel ridiculous whenever a hamster dies, that you're like sobbing because it's just a hamster, it's just a rodent. People kill rodents because they're pests, but there are pets, and they just, you had them for so long, and they're like part of your heart, and they're part of your family, and when they die, it just feels like a member of your family is dying, because to be honest, it kind of is. You welcomed him into your, you welcomed the hamster into your home, you gave it a good life, you cared for it, it is like a member of your family, and it just, it feels harder than most people anticipate. I'm going to insert the slideshow now so you guys can go ahead and watch her, and yeah, I'm really gonna miss her. I really do miss her already. So yeah, I will see you guys soon. I don't know exactly when, but I will see you guys pretty soon with a new video. Enjoy.
We pray for blessings, we pray for peace. comfort for family, protection while we sleep. And all the while, you hear each spoken need. Yet love is way too much to give us lesser things. 'Cause what if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? What if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? What if trials of this life are your mercies in disguise? Pray for wisdom, your voice to hear. And we cry in anger when we cannot feel you near. And all the while, you hear each desperate plea, and long that we'd have faith to believe. 'Cause what if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? And what if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? And what if trials of this life are your mercies in disguise? Friends betray.